Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to explain you about Perlin design in design of steel structures. So this is one example problem, that is symmetric trusses of span 20 meters given, height 5 meters given, which is spaced at 4.5 meters center to center. So for this we need to design a channel section purlin to be placed 1.4 meter distance to resist the loads, and the loads are given, that is weight of sheeting including bolts and live load and wind load. So for this problem we are going to design a purlin, channel section purlin. So here I'll show you the solution. The given data is height of the truss is given 5 meters and span of truss is 20 meters. So we need to find out the slope of main rafter. So rafter is nothing but a sloped member. Suppose our truss member is like this, so we need to find out the slope. So here the span of the truss is 20 meters and the height of the truss is 5 meters. So tan theta equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So 5 meters and half of this truss is 10 meters. So theta equal to tan inverse 5 by 10. I got this value. After that we need to find out design for dead load plus live load. So dead load of sheeting is given and self weight of purlins we are assumed, that is 125 newton per meter square. So total dead load is, by adding both these values, 296 newton per meter square. So live load is given and the factored dead load, that is we know that for steel factored safety, that is 1.5. So 1.5 into these two values. So I got 1.46 kilonewton per meter. Usually the dead load plus live load acts vertically downward. Why? Because due to gravitational force it acts vertically downward. And when it comes to load normal to sheeting, here on purlins, the sheet on top of the purlins we place the sheeting, whether it is an asbestos cemented sheets or galvanized resin sheets. So when load is normal to sheeting we are considering this as a cause, which is an x-axis, and when load direction is parallel to the sheeting we consider this as sine. So 1.46 into sine theta. So 1.46 is nothing but factored dead load plus live load. So I got these two values. After that we are going to find out the bending moment and shear force for zz and yy axis. Why? Because in my previous video already I told you about z axis and y axis, why we are considering the moments, because the bendings of purlins takes place about both yy and zz axis. So due to the biaxial bending, hence these purlins are subjected, we denote that these two purlins are subjected to biaxial bending. So that's why we are calculating moment at z axis and shear force at z axis, and moment at y axis and shear force at y axis. So we are all familiar with this formula, that is the member which is acting, the UDL, entire UDL is carrying on the member, then the bending moment formula is WL square by 8. Here the sheeting is acts as an UDL, and for shear force that is WL by 2. So after substituting all the values I got these values. After calculating this I am going to calculate I'm taking a trial section ISMC 100. So ISMC Indian Standard Medium Channel Section 100. These ISMC properties are available in Steel Tables book or in code book. So D equal to H1 plus 2R1, that is overall depth. So 64, which is available in code book, and 2 into 9, R1 is value, radius of gyration. This value is also available in code book. 2R1, sorry, that's a root of the section. Suppose this is our I section. So R1 is this portion. So here two R1s are there. So that's why I wrote it as 2R1. And H1 is this portion. Okay, like that we are going to calculate this H1 plus 2R1. Okay, from this part, from here to here. Total. So I got 64 plus 2 into 9. That is 82 mm. So after that B value is 50 mm. So ZPZ, that is plastic section modulus required, we need to calculate. So here the formula which is available in code book. Okay, after substituting all the values we'll get the value 42.185. after getting this plastic section modulus we need to check for the shear for this ISMC section. So for this shear strength, we need to refer page number 59, clause number 8.4.1. We will get the values. I mean, this formula is available in this page number 59 for shear strength checking. Like that, in x-axis and in y-axis, we are going to checking the shear strength. After calculating that, have you seen this, which is greater than Fy, that is force, which we get, and this is Fz, which we get in previous step. So hence it is resist shear. This adjacent section resists the shear. So after calculating the shear capacity, we need to design capacity of the section. That is, we need to check whether the section classification. So by using limiting width ratios, which is available in tabular form. In tabular form, IS 800-2007, it is given by B by TF less than 9.4 epsilon. So epsilon equal to root over 250 by Fy. So Fy is yield stress, the value is 250. So 250 by 250 is 1. So epsilon value is 1. So that's why I wrote directly as 9.4. So here B value, we know that 50, and thickness of the flange is 7.5. These values are available in steel tables book. I got 6.67, which is less than 9.4 epsilon. Like that, D by TW, 82 by 4.7. So 82 we calculated, and thickness of the web available in steel tables. I got 17.45, which is less than 42. So the code is specifying that, which is these values are less than 9.4 and 42, the section belongs to plastic section. So after calculating this, we need to calculate MDZ, which is design bending strength. So this formula is available in page number 53, clause number 8.2.1.2. So beta B is equal to 1, because for plastic section, the beta B value is 1, which is specified in code, and ZPZ value is 42.185, we calculated, and Fy is 250. And gamma M0 is partial safety factor. I got the values. Like that, MDY I calculated, I got this value. After that, by referring steel tables book, ZPY value, that is 14208.25, this is for ISMC 100 section. Okay, and the next, we need to calculate this one, MZ by MD, MDZ plus MY by MDY. So in page number 70, the code is specifying this formula. I mean, the design should be satisfy this formula. The code is giving this. So after substituting all the MZ, MY and MDZ plus MDY, I got this value 0.856, which is less than 1. Okay, and next, check for wind condition. So here I'm going to check the wind condition. So factor dead load, that is for the condition of loading, factor dead load, that is 1.5 I'm considering. So I got vertically downward, and dead load reduces net amount about z axis, it increases moment about y axis. In this condition, it reduces the moment at z axis and increases moment at y axis. So hence the load factor should be taken as 1.5. That's why we are considering this as 1.5. And wind load is given, that is 1.2 kilonewton per meter square. So 1.2 into 1.4. So we got 1.68 kilonewton per meter. After that, factor wind load, which is multiplied by 1.5. So the in question, it is given by suction wind load acts normal to sheeting. So normal to sheeting, already I told you that we are taking as cos. So minus 2.52, which is it is downward. Suction means it is drag the force, so it acts as downward, minus 2.52 plus 0.620 into cos theta is 26.565. So I got 1.965 kilonewton per meter outward. So outward is nothing but in wind conditions there are two sides, one is windward and outward or leeward. And load parallel to sheeting, that is sine we are considering, so I got 0.277. After that, MZZ I am calculating, WL square by 8, we know that, and MY by WL square by 8. So I substitute all these values, I got this value. After calculating this, I am going to show you effective length. We need to calculate the effective length of simply supported beam with destabilizing load. That is nothing but, since load do not act through shear center. Here the load does not acting at the shear center, so 1.2L times we need to consider. So 1.2 into the span is 4.5 meters. I mean, we are providing in question, he mentioned that we need to provide the spacing 4.5 meters. So 4.5 meters, I am considering this as an mm. So I wrote it as 4500. So I got 5400 mm. So for R wave value, for ISMC 100 section, R wave value is 14.9 mm. Here I am finding the slenderness ratio, that is KL by RY. I mean nothing but KL by R. So 5400, this is a length, effective length, divided by 14.9. So I got 362.42. But the code is specifying that it should not be greater than 350. For these conditions, the code is specifying that it should not be greater than 350. So hence the section is not safe, which we taken as a trial section, that is ISMC 100, is not safe. So again, we need to devise the section. For that purpose, we need to do one thing. Here I'm revising the section and I'm taking this ISMC 125 as another section. So if we want to know about this class, you need to refer table 3 from IS 800-2007. Okay, after that I'm revising the section. I'm taking as ISMC 125 and RY value is 19.2. again, I'm substituting this value in this equation. I got 281.25. hence it is not greater than 350, hence it is okay. And after that I need to find out the code is specifying h by tf, that is height is 125, which is we consider in the section, and thickness of the flange, that is 8.1. I got 15.43. so why we calculated these values? So after we need to find out the critical stress, so critical stress in the member. So for that purpose we need to calculating these values. So for referring table 14 from IS 800-2007, FCRB critical stress values are there. So for that purpose we need to consider critical stress for these values. So in code, these two values, critical stress values, are not available. So by using double interpolation, we need to find out the critical stress for these values. I'll show you the double interpolation. H by TF, actually our value is 15.43, but in the tabular form we are having the 14 value and 16 value. Why? Because 15.43 is in between 14 to 16. And next here, 281.25 value is in between 280 and 290. So I am considering these values. So now I am going to find out these unknown values, X, O and Y naught. First I am going to find out X value, Y value and O value. Okay, so I will show you the double interpolation. So here, first I calculated X value, FCRB. So 126.9, that is here already I show you. These are the values, 126.9. So by using these values, I did the double interpolation. 16 minus 15.43 by 16 minus 14 and 126.9 minus 111.9. So I got 116.18 Newton per mm square. Same like that at Y I calculated. After finding X and Y, by using these two values, I am going to find out the value in between X and Y, that is for 281.25. this value, for 281.25 value is, I am considering is O. I got X value and Y value. After finding these two values, I am going to find out the O value. Okay, so for from table 13A in IS 800, after finding these O value, I am going to refer from table 13A IS 800, we need to find out FBD value. Before we calculated the critical stress, now I am going to calculate the bending stress. So FBD, so by using single interpolation, I am going to calculate the FBD value by referring 13A in IS 800. Okay, so after that single interpolation, I have done the single interpolation, I got this value, 86.53 Newton per mm square. After that, the code is specifying we need to find out MDZ. So MDZ equal to nothing but beta B ZPZ FBD. So this formula is available in page number 54, that is clause number 8.2.2. So this ZPZ is nothing but plastic section modulus. So FBD already we found here, and beta B is 1 because it is a plastic section, and code is specifying that for plastic section we need to consider beta B value as 1. So ZPZ value is from table 26 IS MC 125. This value is available. Okay, after calculating all this, I got 68.66.8 kilonewton meter. But the code is specifying as per the design, it should be satisfies this equation. So I got 0.344, which is less than 1. Hence, ISMC 125 is adequate. Next, we need to calculate. The last step is deflection. So check for deflection, that is I value, we know that, and W value, we know that, which is available, already we calculated these values. So deflection 5 by 384 into W L power 4 by EI. So I substitute all the values, I got 8.4 mm. But the code is specifying that is, it should be allowed a permissible deflection. So the formula is L by 150. In IS 800-2007, the code is specifying that some permissible deflections are there for these conditions. So that is L by 150. The L is nothing but span, and that is 4500. That spacing we provided the span of the member. So 4500 by 150. I got 30 mm. So permissible deflection is 30 mm, but we got 8.4 mm. So hence it is safe. If it exceeds, if 8.4 mm, this deflection exceeds 30 mm, it is not safe. But here, the deflection, the permissible deflection is 30 mm and we got 8.4 mm. Hence, it is safe. So, provide ISMC 125 as a purlin. So, this is the design of a purlin in design of steel structures. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.